committed, helpful, and safe. If at any time you are not demonstrating those expectations, I, Mother, will turn you into toads and to make sure you pop out the door through the exit. And we don't want that to happen. Please do not use fast photography. Keep your belongings close and your children closer. Don't want them to run into our wicked witch. There will be a 15-minute intermission. Concessions will be offered in a lobby. Remember, every purchase helps us put on our next play. Enjoy the show, my pretties!
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls of all ages, we'd like to welcome you to tonight's performance of The Wizard of Oz. A few things to keep in mind during the show: talking, jumping, dancing, singing, laughing, and interacting with the casting crew is highly encouraged. Also, if you see a Wicked Witch anywhere near the premises, feel free to move to your heart's content. Now, let's give a big warm welcome to tonight's Master of Ceremonies. I'm moving at Bono Storyteller himself, Mr. Nigel D. Narrator!
Paused, we'll come up with a bunch of new options on how to change the story. How's that sound? You guys want to help us all out and create some stage? Sure? Okay. I'm energized. I'm excited. I am ready. Now,
where were we?
Oh, yeah. Dorothy Gale lived in Kansas. She happily resided there on a rural little farm with her Uncle Henry and Aunt Em, both of whom she loved very much.
It's true, I do.
She also loved her little black dog, Toto, and other than her family, it was he who brought the most joy to her life.
Oh, Toto, where are you, boy? There you are. Come here, boy, come here. Come on, what a good boy you are. Yes, you are. Yes, you are.
Touching, isn't it? I don't know about you, but I get kind of bored with the whole Dorothy dog idea. Sad note, how about we make the first change right here and now? Okay, wait for my signal, and...
Toto, I love my life here so much. It makes me want to sing!
Pause!
Pause?
Just for a second. You see, I think me and the audience just want to make one minor change.
That is?
Toto.
What?
Easy, boy.
Toto.
Nothing. We all love him. It's just after the first 100 times or so of hearing this story, you can't help but wonder what the Wizard of Oz would look like if you had a different pet. Something else. Something different. Something mysterious.
But I don't want something mysterious. I want something Toto.
Look, I'll tell you what. In order to make it fair, why don't we put it to a vote? Audience. Would you like Toto to stay a dog, or would you like him to be something else?
Something else!
Well, looks like something else's have it. Sorry, Toto, but you're no longer going to be a dog.
Little.
Instead, you're going to be... I got it. Instead, you're going to be a cow.
What?
Come on. Try it on. Everything that is, except for the occasional, yet highly unpredictable, twister.
Oh, Toto, audience, I'm so very worried. I overheard my Uncle Henry telling Auntie Eb, there's going to be the occasional, yet highly unpredictable, twister visiting these very parts this very afternoon. See?
Em, people are expecting that this will be a twist in these very parts this very afternoon.
Goodness gracious, Auntie, whatever shall we do?
Who knows?
It was then that suddenly, and without much warning, a cyclone half as big as Kansas itself and twice as wide as its inhabitants billowed forth onto the scene and made its way towards Dorothy's farm.
Toto, look! The twister! It's coming! It's coming! Let's run! Run!
Dorothy! Dorothy!
We're coming, too! We're coming! Oh, we're running and running again! We're not getting anywhere! Come on, Toto!
Thank you. was epic. You guys ready for more? The next morning, Dorothy woke with a start.
Whoa! I'm up with a start. And oh, my head. I guess forgetting to lock up those window panes wasn't the best idea. Eh, Toto? Toto? Oh no! Toto, where are you, boy? Thank goodness you're okay. The house! The tornado must have lifted it up and dropped it here with us. But the question remains, where is here? Do you guys know? I normally don't like to ask the audience questions, but in this case, I have no clue as to where we are. Ah! What that is! Oh my gosh, their feet! Our house is your feet. What was that?
And the girl was right, for indeed, still under the great beam of the house that the house rested on, 2 feet were sticking out, shod in silver shoes and painted toes. The girl was beside herself, unaware of what to do next.
I can't believe someone's dead!
At the door now.
Oh, the festivity!
No! This is wrong! I squished someone!
then it's time to remix this up a bit.
Not again.
I know, but hear me out. Audience, usually at this part in the story, Dorothy wears what? Slippers.
Right.
But instead of the same old, why don't we give her something new to wear? That something new can be found in the magical bag of enchantment. Men. Enchantment! Men. It's a special bag with all sorts of options for Dorothy to choose from, so what do you say? Want to give it a shot?
No!
What do you think, Dorothy?
I say never mess with a girl for shoes.
Oh, come on, just give it a try. Help me out here. Please. Terrific.
Okay.
In order to choose from the bag of enchantment, I'm going to need a volunteer from the audience. Gargantuan plants, the likes of which they'd never seen before. As the day pressed on, Dorothy and her furry friend began to grow weary, but they knew that only a persevering would they reach the wizard in a timely fashion. And so, they continued to walk, and walk, and walk, and walk.
I never realized that a road would be so long. I must have been walking for miles.
To be exact, that is if you're coming from Munchkinland.
What was that?
Dorothy searched and searched, but she couldn't tell where the mysterious voice was coming from.
I surely could not.
And suddenly, without warning,
Toto, do you hear?
Hello!
The trio made their way through the thicket of the forest surrounded by darkness. The world before them was still paved in yellow brick, though it was much covered by dried branches and dead leaves. Then the trees, who as luck would have it, stomped alongside our heroes in hopes of shielding them from whatever tricks Mumbai might have up her sleeve. As they continued to walk, they heard the strangest of noises. The noises, it seemed, were growing louder and louder, until finally...
I can't take it anymore! What is it? What is it?
Even closer to the wizard and their magnificent palace made of emeralds. fabulous idea. Personally, my favorite.
Let it be known far and wide that we, the
prepared.
Who was that?
It's me, Nigel, your friendly neighborhood narrator.
Oh no, I'm terrified of narrators. At least I think I am.
Or Eugene. If only you weren't so scared of, well, everything. But despite his flaws, he was still determined.
I am?
He was still a lion.
I know that, right?
He was still a king.
Darn to it.
And above all else, he was still...
Yeah?
He was still frightened out of his wits.
You said it, brother. What am I to do? If I want to keep my kingdom and the respect of my subjects, then I gotta get some courage.
Just then, as if Lady Luck herself had entered the room, our fantastic foursome from Act One, Dorothy, Toto, Jack, and Tinker, emerged.
Dorothy, Toto, Jack, and Tinker? I don't know who or what those things are, but I'm positively positive because I'm awfully awful. I'd better run.
Well, hello there, Mr. Lion. Hi, what a beautiful coat you have. Tell me, would you like to be fed?
I'd better get out of here.
If you ask me, that lion's bigger sort of man.
Shush, you three. He's just nervous is all. Poor guy. Why don't we help him?
As well,
Mr. Lion? Mr. Cowardly Lion, why are you hiding?
You must know, I'm hiding in a big scary place that expects you to be courageous, noble, and responsible all at the same time. And sadly, I don't have the patience or the cojones to deal with it. Now, go away, please. Can't you see I'm wallowing in self-pity?
Poor guy. We should help him.
I suppose for the shop.
Yeah,
oh, have a heart, Tinker. I mean, it'll work out. You'll see. Pardon me for interrupting you again.
Eugene.
Okay, Eugene, but my friends and I would just like to extend an invite to you. See, we're all on our way to meet the wizard to get Jack here.
Howdy.
The brain, and Tinker the Tin Man.
Hello.
A heart. Maybe if the wizard is powerful enough, he could give you some courage as well.
Chuck me, jackass! You really think so? Why, that'd be stupendous. That'd be extraordinary. Imagine it. Me, not afraid of nothing or nobody. What would my parents be proud?
So, does that mean you're coming with us then?
Why, I want to come. In fact, I will come. And when all this is said and done, I'll be the bravest, most masculine lion there is. There's only one thing I need to do first.
Oh, what might that be?
Why, grab my baby blue blanket from the rental horse. I never leave home without it. No, I don't. No, I don't. No.
What do you mean, Toto? Whatever you're saying, we're all the same thing.
And they were off again, Eugene walking with timid strides at Dorothy's side. Toto did not approve of this new comrade at first, but after a time, he became more at ease. And now, Tinker and the Cowardly Lion had grown to be good friends.
Come here, you.
You're just a bunch of harmless flowers.
Yeah, nothing to worry about at all.
Did I fall asleep again? No. This won't do. In case you haven't realized it, the flowers are really evil and use their powers to make our heroes
pass out. Boring, right?
And exhausted. But I think I know how we can fix that, don't you? And with that, she was gone. Dorothy and her friends took Nick's advice and shuffled along, stopping only when necessary.
Move!
And finally... just when they thought their journey would never end, they saw a beautiful green glow in the sky reflecting off the mountaintops. As they continued to walk, the glow became brighter and brighter and brighter. And as soon as they thought they couldn't handle it any longer,
check, lock, maniac.
So what do you say, guys? For Dorothy?
For Dorothy! Sorry. I got caught up in the moment.
And for Toto, too!
All right, guys, here's how it's going to go down. I'm going to whisper a plan and not engage your guys' ear while Nigel here narrates. You guys are quick?
100% and then some.
All right, take it away, Mr. Narrator.
With pleasure, Jack. Jack relayed his plan to Eugene and Tinker, hoping beyond hope that it was clever enough to outwit Mumbai and to save Dorothy. Speaking of Dorothy... horrible of places, the torture chamber of the Wicked Witch of the West. And of course, Mumbai was tormenting our heroine with the most horrible afflictions known to man.
Don't just stand here! Go open the door!
Dorothy couldn't believe her eyes. For one moment, three strangers stood before her, and then the next...
Scarecrow, Tin Man, and Lion, collide!
Three close friends!
Why, I'm so happy you're here. I never thought I'd see you again.
If we thought we'd never see you, even Dorothy.
I just can't believe you risked everything to help me. Were you frightened?
Not the tadpoles. You bet we were. What even then, we?
We were just so worried, but...
Then nothing else seemed to matter.
Well, you guys, you're the best middle-aged adults, single male friends, and young girls could ask for. What?
Now, because the wizard's palace was made of bright shining emeralds, the companions were told to wear green glasses to shield their eyes from the glare. And so, hand in paw, they made their way to the great and powerful throne room of the great and powerful Oz.
About it, this whole ordeal was kind of silly.
probably already guessed, I don't really have any magical power, but I think I can aid you on your journey home.
Wait, really?
Yes, but first, what does the word home mean to you? Wouldn't you say that's exactly what these three fine fellows have given to you since they saved you?
How you might. They did do that for me. And more. Gee, I've been so concerned about going back to my home in Kansas that I failed to realize I created a home for myself right here in Oz with you three.
Boo.
And up here is you too, Toto.
Oh, I guess this isn't time for you, Dorothy. If you want to return back to Kansas, just click your heels 3 times and your enchanted shoes will carry you. But if you want to stay in Oz, and that's a permanent change, mind you, I think I know 3 fine fellows who'd like to have you.
You bet.
Ain't it the truth?
That's right.
Oh, I love you all dearly, but I also love my uncle and aunt. Heaven's Mr. Wizard, I don't know what to do. I'm happy in both places. Which one should I choose?
That is the question, isn't it? But I think I have an idea. Since tonight is all about you, our dear friends, and our dear, dear audience, I think it's right that we let you decide where Dorothy ends up individually.
Yes.
That's a great idea.
Indubitably.
Okay. In order for this to work, I want all of you, each and every one of you, to close your eyes, close them real tight, and think of the place where you want Dorothy to end up. And that's where she'll stay, and that's where she'll live.
I'm picking Oz.
I'm picking Kansas.
And I'm picking Vegas.
Oh, I love this idol. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Sadly, though,
it is here where we bid you and everyone else adieu for the evening.
Hello? And say our goodbyes?
Yes, but first, we not only want to thank you for coming out to our show,
but for helping us tell it in a way we never could have without you.
Nope. And so, as we look out at all your bright, shining faces, wishing you the safest of travels and warmest of car rides, we want to remind you.